Now we'll consider two examples one by one, and then it will become clear for us what is positive electromeric effect and what is negative electromeric effect. Here, although earlier I had written ethene, here now I have selected example of propene. It can be any example. I want to consider alkene. Alkene plus HBr, addition product. HBr gets added across multiple bond, pi bond. This, let me tell you in advance, this is going to be an example of positive electromeric effect. Example of plus E effect. Let us see how and why. Propene will react with H plus ion from HBr. And means addition of HBr takes place in two steps. Normally we write it directly, like what I had shown earlier, action of HBr and action of HCN. But there are stages, steps, mechanism. The first initiation is attack of H plus ion from HBr, of course. And what we obtain is this. This double bond, the second bond in the double, weakly shared, will get transferred to this carbon, and the electron pair which was shared between these two carbon atoms, now it will be shared between carbon and H plus ion. So, it is a covalent bond. The arrow is used only to indicate that the entire electron pair was between these two carbon atoms. Now it is here. Hydrogen has entered in the form of H plus ion, empty orbital. So, the positive charge is developed on this carbon. Positively charged carbon is called as carbonium ion. Carbocation, carbonium ion, positively charged carbon atom. There is a second possibility also. Propene plus H plus can also result in this second possibility. Let me write it. Again, this is carbonium ion. But this is primary carbonium ion. We normally use a symbol 1 degree. It should not be called as 1 degree. It is primary. Although we write in this fashion, we should call it as primary. This is primary carbonium ion, and this one is secondary carbonium ion. On the basis of hyperconjugation effect, this hyperconjugation effect yet we have not considered. After completion of this, it will be possible for us to conclude that tertiary carbonium ion is more stable than secondary carbonium ion, which is more stable than primary carbonium ion on the basis of hyperconjugation. And then it will become easy for us to immediately utter that this one is more stable and therefore this one is a major intermediate, and this one is minor. Although we have not studied yet hyperconjugation effect, although the conclusion of that I have used, even the stability of this secondary carbonium ion and therefore the major product as compared to this, therefore we are going to use this and not this. This can also be explained by using inductive effect, which we have already covered. There are two methyl groups. Alkyl groups have a positive inductive effect, they release the electron density. Two methyl groups, because of the two methyl groups, the electron density in the area of this carbonium ion will increase. It means the unit charge positive, the electron deficiency because of unit charge plus 1. The, since electron density increases here, the electron deficiency will get transmitted to these carbon atoms. It means that the centralized positive charge gets to certain extent decentralized on three carbon atoms. This gives rise to stability of this carbonium ion. Now, if you compare this, whatever I have told you, due to two methyl groups with plus I effect, this secondary carbonium ion is more stable. Here is the ethyl group. The positive inductive effect of ethyl group is more, but positive inductive effect of two methyl groups is more than the positive inductive effect of one ethyl group. So, the electron releasing effect at this carbonium ion, this is primary carbonium ion, and because of that, this centralized positive charge gets decentralized, electron density increases in that carbonium ion, in turn electron deficiency will be developed here to certain extent, giving rise to stability. This factor is of less magnitude than in case of secondary carbonium ion, and hence, although there are two possibilities in the first step, H plus ion react with this electron pair pi, weakly shared electron pair. Although there are two possibilities, this one is major, this is a possibility, but minor, major, more stable, can be explained on the basis of hyperconjugation, a future part, and also on the basis of inductive effect. So, let me rub this now. Addition of HBr to carbon-carbon double bond is under consideration, and first step just now I have covered. Now, the moment carbonium ion is formed, Br minus ion, this H plus ion is from HBr, means bromine will be present in the form of bromide ion Br minus ion. This Br minus ion, positive charge, will attack this carbonium ion, and what we get is this. Isopropyl bromide or 2-bromopropane. The arrow, like what I have told you earlier, is to indicate that electron pair was earlier with bromine, and now it is shared between bromine and empty orbital of carbon, carbonium ion, and therefore it is just to represent. Ultimately, it is shared electron pair, and this is how the reaction takes place. We normally write it directly, addition of HBr and final product. The first step, addition of H plus, actually here is a very important slow step as compared to the second step, and therefore rate of the reaction, ultimately it is addition of HBr, but first step is addition of H plus giving rise to carbonium ion and then attack of bromide ion Br minus ion. This is a slow step, therefore this slow step is called as RDS, rate determining step, which determines the rate determining step. Therefore, this step is important. And now, since the electron pair among the two double bond, the pi electron, since the electron pair gets transferred towards that carbon atom where the reagent gets attached, the electron pair goes to this carbon atom where the reagent gets attached. That is why this example becomes the example of positive electromeric effect. And in the next example, we will consider the opposite of this, minus E or negative electromeric effect. So, this is an addition reaction. Now, what type of addition reaction is this? Now, even in addition reaction, there are two types. Ultimately, it is addition reaction. Ultimately, net reaction is what? Carbon-carbon double bond and addition of HBr. Here I have taken example of propene, it can be ethene, it can be something else, and ultimately what has happened is addition of HBr. But if we study the steps, mechanism, first step is attack of H plus ions, which is a electrophile, and in the second step Br minus, means this is an electrophile, electron deficient, having attraction for electrons, since this is positively charged, having attraction for electrons, electron deficient, this is an electrophile. And in the second step Br minus attacks the carbonium ion, it is negatively charged, it is electron rich, it will attack electron deficient, so this is nucleophile. Still, this addition reaction which we have studied is called as an example of electrophilic addition reaction. Electrophilic addition reaction, it is sometimes written in short in this fashion, EA reaction, electrophilic addition reaction. In the first step it is electrophile, in the second step it is nucleophile. Still, why it is called as electrophilic addition reaction? Because the first step where electrophile attacks is a slow step. The rate of the reaction, the yield depends on first step, therefore it is called as rate determining step. And the moment first step is over, second step is very fast, and therefore this addition reaction is called as electrophilic addition reaction. That is one part. And the important thing is that in the first step the reagent which adds, electrophile in this case, electromeric effect, transfer of pi electrons. Transfer of pi electrons goes to that atom means in this case goes to that carbon atom where the reagent gets added. Therefore, this is an example of positive electromeric effect plus E effect. In the second example, we will see that opposite of this is going to happen. The second example to explain the electromeric effect which I have chosen is going to be an example which comes under negative electromeric effect. Minus E effect. The earlier one was positive electromeric effect plus E effect. This one will be minus E effect. Let us see how. Ultimately, it is addition reaction. Carbon oxygen double bond and addition of HCN, hydrogen cyanide, and it gets added across this multiple bond HCN, hydrogen of HCN goes to oxygen and cyanide goes to carbon. So, like what we had considered in case of addition of HBr, similarly addition of HCN. But if we go through the steps, mechanism, the things are different. HCN during this reaction undergoes what we call as heterolysis, heterolytic breaking, means shared pair, although it is shared between two atoms, the breaking takes place in such a way that the shared pair goes to one of the two atoms. Here, since cyanide group as such is more electronegative, means carbon is more electronegative, which is attached to nitrogen. So, the electron pair remains with carbon, electron of carbon with carbon, and electron of hydrogen atom also remains with carbon, and therefore hydrogen positive charge, and so this is what we get, H plus and cyanide group. In short, we write in this fashion, although there is a triple bond between carbon and nitrogen, electron of carbon and electron of hydrogen, extra electron of hydrogen, therefore minus one charge. Cyanide CN minus ion, H plus ion, heterolytic breaking of HCN. So, this cyanide ion from HCN produced by heterolysis of HCN first attacks the carbon oxygen double bond, carbonyl group. Now, where this will attack? This itself is a negatively charged group, electron rich, will have attraction for electron deficiency, will have attraction for positive. Therefore, this is nucleophile. Carbonyl group itself is polar slightly, oxygen is more electronegative. Therefore, carbonyl carbon, carbon in carbonyl, this group, carbonyl carbon is delta positive, oxygen in this, carbonyl oxygen is delta negative. So, carbon part in carbonyl group is electron deficient, this is electron rich, oxygen is more electronegative, the reason, and therefore, cyanide ion, which is produced by heterolytic breaking of HCN, I had just shown here, just now. This electron pair of cyanide ion, CN minus ion, will attack this carbon. Now, this electron pair, when it attacks and forms a shared pair, the very moment out of these two, the one which is weakly shared, pi, will get transferred to this oxygen. The routine two lone pairs on oxygen are there, I have not shown. Every time it is not necessary to show. And what we get is this, let me write it. electron of oxygen and electron of carbon. So negative charge will be developed on oxygen, and the cyanide with its electron pair forms a covalent bond with carbon. Cyanide, carbon atom of cyanide and carbon of carbonyl group. I have repeatedly told you the arrow is just to indicate that earlier the electron pair was with carbon, now it is shared between two atoms. Or else, after sharing this covalent bond and this covalent bond or the other covalent bonds, the nature is same. This species is formed. The moment this species is formed, then it will pull. Let me write it here. Cyanide group. It will pull the H plus ion from HCN, hydrogen cyanide had undergone heterolysis, CN minus ion first attacks, it is a nucleophile. Then this, in general we can call it as alkoxy group, it will pull back the remaining H plus ion, and what we get is this. The electron pair is now shared between oxygen and hydrogen. Hydrogen had entered in the form of H plus ion, but now it is a covalent bond. So ultimately it is addition of HCN across this. But the first step is attack of nucleophile. In the earlier case, HBr2 propene, the first step was attack of H plus electrophile. Here the first step is attack of nucleophile. Reagent, nucleophilic reagent, and the pi bond in the multiple bond, carbon oxygen double bond, pi bond gets transmitted to more electronegative oxygen, it is but natural, but pi bond gets transmitted to the atom opposite to where the attacking reagent has formed a bond. The attacking reagent forms bond with carbon and pi electrons get transmitted to oxygen. Therefore, this is an example of negative electromeric effect. Earlier, the pi bond got transmitted to carbon atom where reagent had attached. You can revise, you can go back and see that. That is why it was positive electromeric effect, this is negative electromeric effect, that is one thing. So, under the electromeric effect, why the two parts? That is one thing. And second, this is ultimately an addition reaction example. But this type of addition is called as nucleophilic addition, nucleophilic addition reaction, or in short it is written as NA reaction. Earlier addition of HBr to propene was electrophilic addition reaction, you might recollect it. Why this? Because the first step is addition of nucleophile. It is there, but the first step is a slow step. It takes more energy, it takes more time, and therefore this first step, since it is slow step, it is called as RDS rate determining step means if we want to increase the rate or decrease the rate, we have to carry out changes in first step and not in second step. The moment first step is over, the moment attack of cyanide on carbonyl carbon has taken place and this alkoxide, this species is produced, the further capturing, pulling of H plus ion and producing the product, it is very fast. It is very fast. And therefore, this is an example of nucleophilic addition reaction. If the first step is attack of nucleophile, in the second step, this is electrophile. But first step is a slow step, rate determining step, important step. Therefore, this is nucleophilic addition reaction, and the reagent gets attached to carbon atom, and the electron pair in electromeric effect, the electron pair gets transmitted, the pi electrons get transmitted to the other atom. Therefore, this is an example of negative electromeric effect or minus E effect.